restaurants the other day, just asking, you know, where are we going to go from here? Do we have recommendations? What are we going to do? And he didn't answer me. He just said, well, we've got a lot more information to give you guys. We've got a lot more before we make a decision. And he was so professional. He didn't try to lead me, guide me, influence me. He just constantly gave me information. But the key term that stuck in my mind was to persevere. And Craig, I think you had to persevere. I don't know how you did it. I went and looked it up. It says to maintain a purpose in spite of difficulty, obstacles, or discouragement, and to continue steadfastly. And you guys have done it. You've done it. For all the years I've been here, I've seen you do it in our community. And I just wanted to stand and applaud you for what you've done, your effort, your steadfastness. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Commissioner Crowder. Let's move to item number one, rank number one. What's the recommendation of the, what's the pleasure of the commission? Commissioner Mark Sanchez.
Mr. Chairman, commissioners, I would recommend that we double the funding for conservation through the commission. I'll make a motion to suspend. But it be subject to a more comprehensive approach to include public education, public goals, decreasing block rate structures, outdoor mining restrictions, and weed protection programs. That's my motion.
Second.
We have a motion been made and seconded. We need to increase the funding to $3 million for item number one and approve it with the additional recommendations. Discussion. Hearing none, all those in favor.
Excuse me, if I might, I have two legal issues that I'd like to raise before I go to taking on this issue, on this proposal rather. The first is, in order to make this money available to the various municipalities, a joint powers agreement or something of the sort will have to be entered into by the Gila Conservation Coalition, the Interstate Stream Commission, and those beneficiaries. We cannot give money to the cleanup directly, otherwise we get an environmental issue plus issue. So I want you all to be aware of that. That's the first issue. The second issue is, with respect to funding this project and many of the others that are on the table today that require some sort of matching funds, I highly recommend that this commission figure out an end date by which that match needs to be provided. Otherwise, you're going to have these open-ended hanging obligations. So bear that in mind. Thank you.
Thank you. That is an allocation.
Mr. Chairman, yes, it is. And again, I think the idea is simply to do more than offer rebates. And conservation is the highest rated project, has the highest rate of return. And symbolically, it's something that we should be looking
at. Mr. Chairman, could Amy read back what that motion would actually be? How does the additional information he just added fit in with what you already have in here? I just want to make sure I understand what I'm voting on before I get there, please.
Mr. Chairman, I think the idea was that there was a matrix provided in the recommendations and report by county, which included what they might do with that funding. The idea is to make it uniform in all four counties after develop a joint powers agreement, or whatever the mechanism is, a more comprehensive conservation plan, and all of them include all those components.
And that would be in addition to the money shall remain in the fund until and reimburse the municipalities. The municipalities will have to put it out new reimbursement. It would mean that the funding would be administered by the ISC. In other words, we're blending that into the staff's recommendation. Is that correct?
Correct.
I believe so. I do highly recommend that you have an end date in mind in terms of disbursement of that funding from the fund. relative to the provision of the match.
Mr. Chairman, on that point, could I just inquire, if we pick a date, let's say December 31st of 15, which is roughly 12 months, can we extend that at a subsequent meeting? If the commission votes in the majority to do so.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioner Henderson, certainly. I think as long as this commission votes in an open public meeting to extend that deadline, I think that's acceptable.
Well, I think with some of the local governments involved, and I'm not picking on these local governments, I'm saying all local governments, sometimes a drop-dead date serves a useful purpose because it sort of provides for a specific date that you have to make a decision about. So I would support that as a seconder to this and be willing to encourage it to be applied as the director has suggested. So I'm a little unclear of the date. That's my point.
Mr. Chairman, I thought the recommendation of the Wellness Proposal was within 10 years. The funding. 2020 is the date that comes to mind. But perhaps if we said within 24 months, the mechanism, the plan being developed to go forward.
With the idea that if somebody needed, had good reason for additional time, it's hard to imagine there wouldn't be understanding.
2020 date is in the
proposal. But 2020 date is all the funds must be expended.
That's right. Putting that out, yeah.
But I think he's saying that they've got 24 months to get the joint powers agreement, all the plans put together, everything's going to be different. I like the shorter string.
Mr. Chairman, I think we've amended the motion to repeat about four times. So if you just remake the motion as it's been put together so everybody understands it, we'll see what you're saying.
I think we have a second. No, we say the motion.
I'm opening it up to you, Mark. Can you say the motion?
That the funding for the conservation be increased to $3 million, subject to a more comprehensive approach to public education, public goals, increasing block-based structures, under lottery restrictions, and leak protection programs, and that the joint powers agreement or adequate mechanism be developed, and it was the plan in 2020 years, and that all funding must be expended by 2020.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second.
Mr. Chairman,
Mr. Thank you, Bureau. We'll take your second. Any discussion on the motion? Commissioner Blaine.
As I mentioned, our review of the project, and this project is, I think, part of one of the requirements that I'll ask requiring this money for this project proposal is that the region, or whether it's by county, municipality, that if you set a target per capita of use that they work towards project conservation program. Thank you.
Further discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor of the motion signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried. Let the record show that Commissioner Harris voted yea. Item number two, Southwest Regional Water Supply. Pleasure of the question.
Mr. Chairman, I would move adoption of the staff recommendation. This, without a doubt, is the most difficult of the various alternatives for me personally. However, I think under the circumstances of New Mexico's drought conditions and the fact that so many New Mexicans rely on water resources, that the staff recommendations make sense to me to not lose this New Mexico water to Arizona. So I move adoption of the second staff proposal.
Is there any discussion on the motion? Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Chairman, thank you. I'd like to
to just make a statement on this item, if I might. I'm going to read some notes that I've been jotting down here this afternoon. The New Mexico Interstate Stream Commission is charged with leading state and regional water planning in the 16 planning regions. The role of regional water planning is to identify and implement strategies to balance supply and demand in the region for the long run. Planning, in my opinion, should be an all-of-the-above approach. We'll have all of your eggs in one basket. The item we just voted on, municipal conservation, is appropriately ranked high. I'm really encouraged that it ranked high at the highest benefit-cost ratio. But if it's a good idea today, it was also a good idea 5 years and 10 years and 15 years ago. And I'm personally appreciative of the fact that municipal conservation got a good ranking. I'm personally disappointed that it's been used as a leverage to try and keep other proposals from moving ahead. Few of New Mexico's regions have an opportunity to develop new water. This one does. And we encourage regional solutions to water supply. I am concerned with the cost and with the willingness and ability to pay by the proponents. Willingness seems apparent. Ability to pay is not yet, I think, completely vetted. However, I'm personally unwilling to preclude the development of this water to New Mexico by preventing it from going to the next step. So thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Any further discussion? Remarks next.
Mr. Chairman, just to clarify, what the motion includes is simply a notice to the Secretary of the Interior that the planning is out to heal. And then we are here at decade or two from any real impacts on the heal.
Staff recommendation is to notify the Secretary. Yes.
And, Mr. Chairman, there are 5 other bullets on the staff recommendation here involving additional steps. It is the notification to the Secretary of Interior that is the most time-sensitive, as pointed out in the staff recommendation. But I'm embracing all of those recommendations.
Thank you.
My motion.
Thank you. Mr. Blaine, changes.
Reflecting on the security lines, comments, I too agree with what he says, that you heard my earlier comments regarding this project proposal. While I am in agreement, as I said, with Mr. Secretary Behind's statements and our duties to IEC, I have reservations in one, the ability to pay for this, not just necessarily the end users, I think. As you indicated, there is a willingness to pay, but I think the in-between getting to that point that we can pay is a question. My earlier comment made that, you know, I really haven't heard from those individuals that would be the ones leveraging funding. Are we going to get it from the state? Are we going to get it from the feds? It's been silent, so, you know, not hearing anything public or privately regarding that. It makes me hesitant to go forward, not in the sense of not supporting this project, but the details of who's going to pay for it or how it's going to be paid for. And as I indicated, also there's other details because it hasn't been fully vetted or looked into 10%, or we're looking at 30% now. And perhaps if I was at a 30% level and having more information, I would provide full support. But I guess I just want to qualify my position. Thank you.
Mr. Crowder.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just a comment before we vote. There were points of time through this process where light bulb moments happened in here. And so one of mine is a fear of a stranded asset or getting into something that can't be used and useful. And my decision basically came when I realized, or when staff educated me to the point that we can do this in phases, and in fact, if we do phase one, we almost have enough funding now to do phase one. If it were to do a diversion, a tunnel, in a small spark, we
53,645 acre feet. It would provide a flow when the river is dry to put water back in the river to keep the fish alive. And when I realized that just phase one of this becomes used and useful and will save fish, it changed my perspective on the whole project. It may be a while before we get phase two. We may not have the funding, but the funding we have available will do phase one and it's used and useful. And when I kind of arrived at that spot, I realized that this is a good, this is a good project.
Chairman, I request that the record reflect that I did not vote on this issue.
Thank you, Commissioner Carroll. I believe the Secretary has a resolution that we should consider at this time.
Yes, Chairman, thank you. In light of that that decision, I believe it appropriate that the Commission consider the following resolution. Resolution of New Mexico's Interstate Stream Commission regarding the notification of the Secretary of Interior pursuant to the 2004 Arizona Water Settlements Act. Whereas the Arizona Water Settlements Act, AWSA, was passed by Congress and signed into law by the President in 2004 as Public Law 108-451. Whereas the AWSA allocates to New Mexico an annual average of up to 14,000 acre feet consumptive use of additional water from the Gila Basin in New Mexico, and two, between 66 and 128 million in non-reimbursable federal funding. Whereas the AWSA mandates that the New Mexico Interstate Stream Commission, make the final determination regarding how the additional water and the money available to the state under the Act will be utilized. Section 212D1 and Section 212I, respectively, of the AWSA. Whereas, pursuant to the AWSA, New Mexico must provide notice to the Secretary of Interior no later than December 31st, 2014, if it intends to develop the additional water through the construction of the New Mexico unit of the Central Arizona Peninsula, and whereas the Commission voted on November 24, 2014, in an open public meeting to pursue the development of a diversion and storage project through a New Mexico unit of the Central Arizona Project. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the New Mexico Interstate Stream Commission, through its chairman, Mr. Jim T. Dunlap, will notify Ms. Sally Jewell, Secretary of the United States Department of Interior, on or before December 31st, 2014, that the state of New Mexico intends to have constructed or developed the New Mexico unit of the Central Arizona Project. Approved this 24th day of November at the meeting of the New Mexico Interstate Stream Commission held in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Signed, Jim T. Dunlap, Chairman. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
You've heard the resolution. What's the pleasure?
Move for approval of resolution.
Yep. Second. Motion been made and seconded by Commissioner Harris. Second. Any discussion on the resolution? Commissioner Mark.
Mr. Chairman, just to clarify, perhaps any chance of matter is whether the resolution falls under our existing agenda of approval of projects.
Mr. Chairman, Commissioner Sanchez, I believe it does. So long as the resolution is approved today.
Even though I qualified my opposition to the project, I didn't qualify that I am in favor of the concept of the storage and diversion. In fact, this kind of information that I feel comfortable with.
further discussion? All those in favor of the resolution signify by saying aye.
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 All opposed? Hearing none. Let the record show it is unanimous. Go to item number three, Gila Basin Irrigation Commission's irrigation diversion structures. Pleasure to the commission. Commissioner Wilcox moved to approval. Commissioner Harris, you want to second it?
Yes.
Motion been made and seconded. Any discussion? Commissioner Pratt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is one of the diversion that I think we need to put the funding in. I would ask my colleague to consider a friendly amendment, and that we add an additional $500,000 to this irrigation diversion, so that they would have a fund. They would still have $400,000 to skin and gain. But I would like to see this. I think we're dangling a large carrot in front of them to try to get it done. But I also see a long time frame to go through the Water Trust Board or some of the other processes, and I'd like to see it accomplished sooner rather than later. So I would ask them. I'd like to make a motion to amend it to include an additional $500,000 for this budget.
Is there a second to that amendment? Motion made and seconded. Any discussion on the amendment, which is